So, if you haven't had your head under a rock, you'll be aware that the last episode of Breaking Bad aired recently. Well, as sad as everyone was at Head Squeeze, it inspired us to look at the science behind the show a little bit more. It's also timely, as we're now all prepared to fight off the first of the season's cold and flu. The two are intrinsically linked by synthetic chemistry. In the States, you'd be hard pushed to find our favourite decongestant, pseudoephedrine. The 24-hour shop down the road can't stock it because the government insists that it has to be sold by a pharmacist, and if you do find a shop that can stock it, it's no doubt out of stock. Yet, now there is a solution. Last year, a paper was published on how to synthesise your own decongestant from crystal meth, which means you're one phone call to your dealer and you're simply a chemical synthesis away from once again having freely flowing nasal passages. So how do we know that we can make one thing from another? Well, it's all to do with synthetic chemistry. Most drugs are made of sort of carbon skeleton with other bits stuck on it. And the ability to make these sort of structures is what makes its chemistry so interesting and versatile. Sometimes small changes in the structure can have a big difference, and the carbon structures of both crystal meth and pseudoephedrine are very similar despite their very different uses. That OH is all that we need to change. Now, we can't just stick an OH on there with a small pair of tweezers. If you try to make a single dose that way, around 30 milligrams, you need to do that 900 trillion trillion times to get enough molecules. And I don't have enough time for that. What we do in the lab is use something called chromium hexacarbonyl to bind and activate the right point on the molecule so we can deliver a small change to all the molecules in the right location. When we remove the chromium off the molecules, we then have our own personal stash of decongestant. Now, if you're thinking this sounds all very simple and what made Walter White so special, and that even Jesse could handle this, well, isn't actually all that simple at all. Converting an off-the-shelf drug into something with more street value requires specialist knowledge and ingredients. Red phosphorus is key to the chemistry discussed in Breaking Bad, but red phosphorus isn't that readily available. More importantly, if you do find someone who can sell it to you, it's not before long that the police will turn up and start asking some really difficult questions. You might wonder if white phosphorus would work instead, and sadly it's not as easy as that. Firstly, the difference between red and white phosphorus is much like the difference between diamond and graphite, you know, used to make the lead in pencils. They're both the same element, but the difference in the arrangement of the atoms results in very different behaviours. And that isn't just limited to chemistry. Try proposing to the love of your life with a graphite engagement ring. The second problem is that white phosphorus is also a chemical weapon, so it's still not that easy to get hold of, and when you do get hold of it, it has a nasty habit of just catching fire. So the quick route of taking one drug and turning it into another has its difficulties. What about making it from scratch, building it up step by step? Now that's where Walter White's genius as a really good chemist made him formidable as Heisenberg. Every step has side reactions and unwanted products. Some of your expensive starting stuff gets lost along the way. A really good chemist can minimise these problems by doing simple things like not spilling it on the floor. But even if they get 90% of their starting material converted into products at each step, over 20 steps, that would still mean they only get around about 10% of their final product, due to all those losses along the way. And whether you're a pharmacist or a drug dealer, that really starts eating into your profits. So there you go, being a high quality drug dealer is hard, but if you have a blocked up nose and you're willing to give it a go, you can always clear those sinuses.